Who Season 1, Episodes 5 to 11, titled The Daleks. Of course, this is the introduction to the most iconic villain of the entire show. And it's quite interesting because I'm like, okay, let me put on my hat. Let me have a perspective of 1963 that these characters have never been appeared before, and it blow their mind away. And mainly children, because Doctor Who at the beginning of its history, it was aimed for children. And you're trying to say, okay, what made them the things that they are now? And you're just watching this episode, and all you can tell is, like, they thought these villains were going to be one-shots. That they would hear these villains called the Daleks, these robots, and they'll be in, like, 7 episodes, and they'll move on to whatever it is. Because, you know, they didn't know that these villains were going to be popular. They didn't know that this show is going to be celebrating its 60th anniversary next year. Like, they didn't know all the stuff that we know now. And I'm watching it, and I'm like, it's just... Like, the story itself, like, okay, in episode 4, you have the Doctor, you have Susan, you have Barbara, and you got Ian, right? And they find themselves trapped on an alien planet. The TARDIS is kaput, and they need to find Mercury. And the only way to get some Mercury, is possibility, is over that city. And in that city is run by the Daleks, and we find out the planet... The planet is Starro, and they get Wesh, and then they get captured by the Daleks, and they try and have this kind of partnership, and you know, you feel that the Dalek, at the beginning, the Daleks might mean no harm, they maybe just acting hostile because they didn't know them, and then slowly we find out, no, the Daleks are just assholes. And at the beginning, I'm like, okay, this is a neat story, I kind of like it, it's very straightforward, simple, or neat, you know, it's just like, hey, the Doctor will get his Mercury, the one, the TARDIS, and they're going to get right back to the TARDIS and get the fuck out of there, get the fuck off of Starro. But I looked at Brickbox, and I'm like, how many episodes is in this, like, story? And I'm like, 7 parts, like, nearly 3 hours long. What is there to tell? What smart story do you need? Like, the only thing I can see that made the Daleks popular is the exterminator, and their maybe design, and in 1993, the people just, you know, for that design look cool. And of course they updated through the times and all that. But I'm watching it, and I'm like, what else to be? What else? Like, I'm like, I'm following the beats, and I'm like, Mercury, and then they'll get captured, and realize the Daleks are not that, are just assholes, and they'll hop off back to the TARDIS and onto the third story. But no, that is not the case. What you have is this B plot that is uninteresting as hell, and feels like we are in a separate thing. It feels like the second story of the Daleks. It feels like the story that you tell when the Daleks become popular. That, you know, there is this race. That there are these people that the Daleks have been at war with. And they're trying to be peacekeepers. And trying to end as much as they can. And all that. And I'm like, I just don't care about it. I felt like you know why, the reason why I didn't really care for the people, the war that the Daleks are facing, but it's simply this: it felt tacked on. It felt like we just wanted to extend some more story. We felt like we need to drag this out more, and it just didn't really appeal to me. It just didn't, like, I just, like, I don't care. I mean, you know, It feels like horrible. It's horrible, horrible stuff. But I just felt like you had this very simple plot: get the Mercury, meet the Daleks. You get captured. You get your Mercury, and then you get out because you know the Daleks ain't that friendly. Yeah, I'm like, do that. That's simple as hell. That's like what, 3, 4 episodes, boom. But in reality, you add an extra 5 of them, extra 3 of them. It just becomes drag, and the again, you want to add the whole master way thing. I understand that the Daleks don't like anything that isn't them, and you know, and if you don't know, yes, the Daleks are based on the Nazis, which I regret when I did when I reviewed The Boys season 2, and when Stormfront going out got revealed that she was a Nazi, that I didn't do my best Dalek impression, that I didn't go on Audacity and try to make myself into a Dalek, except I did the shittiest German accent that you can ever think of. But and they talk about, you know, but you know, the Daleks are based on the Nazis, and talk about, you know, the master ways and all that kind of stuff. And you're just like, I felt like it felt like all the information, it felt like all the information that we know the Daleks to be happening like in another story. Like, well, I'm looking through the first episode, like, what's it, the invasion, that, you know, the Dalek invasion, whatever it's called, the one with them in London, and you know, probably the first ever Dalek invasion in the show's history. But it's just weird. I felt like that could be it, where they talk about the master, you know, talk about the whole exterminating things and all that. But it's just, I just couldn't. I enjoyed the beginning, but then the more the story go on, I was kind of waiting it to move on, and I was waiting to go to edge of what's the next one? Ed's Edge of Destruction, which is only 2 episodes, which is kind of surprising. Edge of Destruction, which is only 2 episodes, but and that one's all about the Dalek, about the TARDIS, you know, crashing, so a whole episode on the TARDIS. But it's I just, yeah, I was kind of really looking forward to it, to be like, hi, here comes the Daleks, here comes the big bads, yeah, let's see their debut. Isn't that, well, interesting beginning? Didn't we care much when we were going on through the episode, out through the story?